Frankie was doing Wormaconda, so I better go over some details on that. So when Carl gets into his Wormaconda position,
we're there.
He needs to make sure to turn this way, bro. But his elbow is clamping over my Yes, his elbow needs to be connected to that, if that makes sense. So he goes for the Jean-Claude and I do this. He's to come to this position here, yeah. So again, notice the way Carl's right knee is the inside space and my leg is under his legs. If my knee occupies that space, yeah, from there I can take Carl's back. Make sense? So watch, this is the detail. From here, anytime I end up in Wormaconda position, I need to keep my elbow over that leg. That makes sense? Because you won't end up perpendicular when you hit that backward row sweep. So of course I go for the reaction, I try to put him down, he puts his hands on the mat, and watch what happens when I kick. If I stay connected to him, I'm perpendicular. Notice the way my knee is on the mat, and I have Carl's leg between my legs. If I'm sloppy with the inside knee, and Carl gets his knee inside mine, it's on my back. This is the battle of inches that you have to do when you're playing the lapel guard. One movement and you're kind of losing position. So you want to be thinking about staying tight with the lapel coming up. So just from Wormaconda, come on the lapel and push it down. Turn around and come that elbow hugging. First sweep and put it down. Kick him in the butt and stay connected with my knee. So when I take him over, I have inside knee position and his legs between my legs. So now I find the shin, bring him down, and on the back. Okay, let's look at another scenario whereby you've got people that have done gymnastics for 20 years and you won't be able to hit them with that sweep and just handstand. So let's look at that scenario with Worm. So from here, need to get inside control. So we're struggling to get inside control. It's not about doing yoga. I come up on my elbow and move my hip back. Swim inside. Now Wormaconda is all about my limbs are inside his limbs. I go to Jean-Claude, he puts his hands on the mat. I go to backward roll sweep and he widens his base with his hands and we end up here. So I can't take him over. So watch this hand finds the pants. I bring it in. Watch what I do with my left knee. I shelf it. I'll put him straight into the saddle. Of course we've covered all this in the no-gi stuff, but it's even better. I've got the lapel now. So we have a couple of options from here. They're all illegal for white belts, but don't worry about that. So we come in, I'm gonna feed my left hand under the top leg, physically grab my lapel. And I'm gonna let go, pinch my knees. Now I'm just arching back for Achilles. Maybe I messed that up. I'm amazingly pushing this out of the way and popping straight into my knee bar. So again, knee bar basics. I want Carl's knee above my hip. I curl my heels back. 90 degree bend at the back of your knees. 90 degree bend between your legs and your sternum. He wants to do the elastic back. I can't have his knee facing away from me. So my head pushes down on his big toe. My free right hand pulls up on the heel and I make a mat-a-lay-on grip. Okay, so Carl tries to do that escape again. And now I just arch. Okay. Be careful on that. Let's do that again. From single leg X, he tries to stuff this knee. I just pull the lapel. That's why the entrance from Anaconda Guard is so much easier. Because my legs are on the inside. Hug. Okay. Jean-Claude. Put his hands on the mat. releases. Now they can't grab that leg because he's keeping it away. I can use my foot. With my foot, I can pull it in with my foot. But I can't, I need the knee now. If his knee's tucked, I can't get this. So you need to make a grip and physically pull his left knee past my left hip. Now he just put him straight in his body. So, first submission is keep the lapel. We're going to be going buck mad trying to escape. On a wee pit, there's no gi, it's a wee bit difficult to sit back there. It's class. So I just dig under. I want the sharp bit of my wrist under his Achilles. And I'm going to, because I have a lapel, so I can finish this one handed. We just come in and I physically make a grip on the lapel here. Feet come hip to hip. Now you need to lean back with the lapels restricting me. So now it's just this. If I can't get that, just be pushing out of the other one and be sheer luck. There's another one here. Again, if I lose the knee line, we discussed this when we were playing the noogie stuff, we messed up. So I need to keep his knee above my hip. I mean, if he pulls it out, it's not the end of the world. I can move my hip back in again. So I fall onto my side, get a bend here, push down on my head, out of the arm grip, and now from there, just making sure I'm tight and like a ball. Make sure when you're drilling your Wormaconda, it's important to remember the concepts that we talked about on week one. Whereby, when I'm here, that my right foot is kicking out this way, putting pressure on his hip. I cover the knee. Again, we always go, get the reaction, get the hands on the mat, bring him up, find out, pull him in.